If we unraveled the Lake Superior shoreline into a highway, it would extend 1,826 miles. That's the distance from Duluth, Minnesota to Miami, Florida. But despite its large size, the shoreline is just one small part of a highly complex system, one that extends far beyond the lakeshore community. And the effects of climate change, mixed with the impacts of human activity, are turning that system on its head.
The temperature impacts are caused because we remove streamside vegetation in some cases, so the stream water warms up more. We also add impervious surfaces, parking lots and roads and rooftops, and when rainfall hits those surfaces, they warm up quite a bit. And so then when they get into our streams, it warms the stream up, and we've seen temperature jumps of 10, 12 degrees over 5 or 10 minutes in our streams after a rainfall event because of those warm waters running off of parking lots and other impervious surfaces, up to the point where the trout in those streams would be severely impacted. The other prediction is that we're going to have larger storm events or more frequent large storm events. And so those bigger storms are going to also bring more water into our streams. That extra volume is going to just increase the erosion. Instead of water getting trapped on the land, it runs right off into our streams very quickly. And those huge volumes of water basically remake the stream channels and rip out the banks and pull that sediment into the streams and carry that sediment downstream, smothering habitat, harming the fish directly, carrying extra nutrients, carrying a little bit of mercury.
Sediment in the water column is a stressor for fish. It gets into their gills. It makes it difficult for them to see. Sediment also carries with it nutrients. So that means that you're bringing in a much higher amount of nutrient along with the sediment. So that causes algal growth to increase. People tend to clear the vegetation away from the shoreline just because they're interested in seeing a view of the lake. If you remove the trees, you get more heating at the ground level. So removing vegetation, especially when you substitute paved surfaces or rooftops, that tends to disrupt the hydrologic cycle. The initial response for most homeowners is to say, I don't live right on the lake, so what I'm doing isn't going to affect Lake Superior. A lot of work is being conducted now to try and understand how it is that you get the message to people about how what they're doing in their piece of land influences what happens downstream and ultimately Lake Superior.
Many of the things that we have to do to deal with the problems of stormwater and non-point pollution that we have right now are also going to help us adapt to the changes that we expect for climate change. Things like rain garden and planting more trees and keeping our forests in place so when those big storm events come in, they don't have as great an impact on our streams. All of the things that we have to do for stormwater are also going to help us adapt to climate change, which is even more impetus, I think, for working with communities to help them get their stormwater issues figured out as soon as possible.